Hello, everybody. My name is Greg Janiscoli, and that was the North Jersey Region Audition excerpt for bass drum for middle school and junior high school. So this one has no rolls. I'm only going to use one mallet, and we start with repeated quarter notes from piano all the way up to forte over the course of five bars. I would say look at the music, and you can find the link right below the video so you can follow along. I'm going to muffle just a little. It's kind of like a half mute of the drum head, so that each new quarter sounds clean. There's still a roundness to the sound, but it also doesn't start to just rumble instead of having a sense of rhythm to it. And what I'll do is, to test it, I'm going to leave the mute on and play some. And then I take it off and see if I can pretty much match those two sounds. That means I'm doing it correctly. All right, now if I want to muffle for real and really stop the sound, I'll put my knee against the head there like that, and I use the fingers on the other side doing the same. If my knee's tightly against this head, these fingers are tightly against the other head. If I'm just partially muffling to get a round sound but still clarity, I barely touch it with the knee and I barely touch it with the fingers. And if it's open here, it's open on the other side with the fingers. All right, so we're going to crescendo from piano to forte. Now we're right back to the half muting. I might have done a little too much that time. Fortissimo. With a rest after it. So I'm really going to muffle on the rest. And remember, a forte half note with an accent is basically the same dynamic as fortissimo. So however loud I played bar 5 is how loud I come back in bar 6 with the fortissimo. The next measures in piano, it's quarter notes that are staccato. So I'm going to muffle on the ands. I'm going to give each staccato note half of its value. One and two and one and two and. Like that. All right? Now we have a rhythmic pattern. It's staccato. I'm going to keep the knee sort of half on, and then I muffle on 2 because it's a rest. Then back to half on, open. So here, in this measure or 2, it's pretty complex. This is the second line, 4th and 5th measure. The only real muffle I'm going to do is on the 2 where the rest is. The rest of it is half on, except the dotted quarter with the tenuto marking is... I'm going to be an open there, all right? And then I'll muffle on the downbeat, which is the rest of the last bar. Again. And here we have Let Vibrate. I put the mallet down, and I'm just going to then gradually decay the drum a little faster to move things along like that. This just uses one of the Tom Geiger number 1s, and I used to just use the old Corpsmaster mallets because that's a lot of times what students find in the band room, and they're okay. I think for the rolls they're a little too harsh. You can hear each stroke instead of like a long sound for certain roll passages, so I've avoided them. I just want to try a few things here. We have Tom Geiger number 2, which is a very big mallet. I might use this in some key spots in Rite of Spring that just have a big sforzando note. Let's see. Maybe it'll overpower the piano, but we'll find out. I kind of like it. That's a Tom Geiger number 2. So, thank you for listening, everybody. Take care.